Dan Smolenski. Welcome to episode 4 of the Cauldron. Winter Track is in the midst of one of its best seasons in history. They are led by freshman sensation Autumn Arnofsky, as she currently leads the state in the 55-meter dash. She is a part of a very talented freshman class whose potential is off the charts. Girls basketball is still in the upper tier Division 1 as they currently sit at 9-3. Jordan Franzen sits tied for 4th in the state in scoring as she's averaging 17 points a game. They have Alvern and Goffstown on the schedule next week. Ice hockey's in a bit of a slump as they've dropped the past two games, but they look to rebound this week against Hanover and Nashua North. Wrestling only has 3 losses in Division 1, and they look to end their season on a high note as they have Wyndham on their senior night next week. Boys basketball lost their first game of the season to a very talented Exeter team in a defensive showdown last Tuesday, but they rebounded for their biggest win of the season in a 41-35 win over undefeated Winnicunnet. There's a lot of hype surrounding the boys basketball team this season, and I sat down with head coach Rob McLaughlin to discuss this exciting season. All right, guys, I'm here in the studio with head coach Rob McLaughlin. Coach, thanks for coming here to talk to us.
Thanks for having me.
So, you guys currently sit at 1 loss this season, your lone loss coming to an undefeated Exeter team. I mean, it's kind of easy to ask, but, you know, how is the season going so far?
We've been pretty thrilled. We've had, you know, the kids have responded real well coming in. They're playing well together. They're very disciplined, playing unselfishly. We've been preaching that from the beginning. So our defense has really carried the day for us early. And hopefully we can continue it as we get going.
Now, in the past, and the general consensus around the state of Salem basketball is you run a defensive-minded game plan. You know, you guys have a little thing called the under 55 club, where you like try to keep teams under 55 points. How has that philosophy changed at all with this season, or are you just still going with it?
No, I think it's something we've done historically, and this group's just really bought into it. They're really sacrificing and doing their roles. We do have our little under 55 club, and you know, we got something downstairs in the locker room to identify the games that, you know, it's one of our daily goals. And we identify that along with some other things that we think are going to make us successful. And with this group, we came up with the thought that if we can keep teams down and we can be aggressive defensively, that we're going to, you know, give ourselves a chance every night. And ultimately, that's all we can ask for when it's said and done.
So Salem came into the season with a lot of hype on us. New Hampshire Sports Page has us number 6 in the state. We're currently now at number 3. How do you think the guys on the team have reacted to that, you know, preseason ranking and how they've kind of pushed it this season?
I think they've reacted pretty well. We talked about it. We didn't run from it. We didn't do anything like that. And we told them the preseason rankings are great, and it's nice to get recognized, and it's nice for people to think that you're pretty good. But you got to go out and you got to prove it every night. And that's been our mantra from the beginning. It's one game at a time. You know, if you want that respect and you want people to continue talking about you, you need to go earn it. And that happens on a daily piece in practice, and then it translates into the game. So that's kind of been our theme going through it. Let's prove them right more than anything else.
So this year, you've really had a lot of leadership has stepped up this year. You have Zach Caraballo, who's a 3-year varsity guard. He's starting. Him and Trevor Domenico have, you know, many people are combining. They've combined for one of the best backcourts in the state. How are they doing this year in response to that, and just how are they playing in general?
I think they're doing pretty well. They offensively, we've known from the beginning that they can score. They can shoot it really well. I've been more thrilled with their defense more than anything else, and it goes back to what, you know, we push on a daily basis. But we have Ben Laycock in the back now with some size, so he's kind of opened some stuff up and let these guys jump passing lanes and be a little bit more aggressive and take a few more chances. And that's been huge for us. I think it puts a lot more pressure on the other team just on making an everyday pass. And they've really responded. And then we can get out in transition, and when they're in the open court, they're pretty tough to defend because they can handle it and finish at the rim as well. So I've been thrilled with them.
So speaking, you know, finishing at the rim, one person we've definitely seen is with Kyle Poole in this year. Has really stepped up, especially in the paint and on defense. How has he improved over the past couple of years?
We kind of saw this come in the last couple of years. As a sophomore, he really didn't get a lot of minutes. But he was in practice every day working and making sure he was getting better. He was going up against, you know, Griffin Curtis and Matt Vartanian years ago. And we asked him to buy into the process and understand why we were doing what we were doing. And he did. He came in every day. He worked his tail off. And as last year went on, we could slowly see the steps increase and increase. And we'd keep looking down going, we got to keep him in the game. We got to keep him in the game. He's just taken that now to another level this year. He's really playing with a lot of confidence. He's got a lot of quick, decisive, you know, little deceptive moves that he uses in the paint, uses his body really well. And, you know, he's vital. He kicks the ball well. His improvement over the last 3 years has been tremendous.
So to touch on, you know, that year number 5, you know, Jared Burns, yep, who is didn't get as much time in the past couple years, but this year, you know, he's broken in the starting 5. Mm-hmm. How has he been playing this season overall?
He's been great. He's been giving us exactly what we need. We came in knowing that his role was going to be to kind of cover the other team's best player on most nights, give us a little length in that department and get tips and get little buckets when they're available, knock down an open shot. He knew from the beginning what that was and what we were going to ask of him, and he's embraced it, and I think he's done a real good job with it. And then Michael Ferentz kind of gives us that same role when he comes off the bench with it. So I think those two have kind of filled that really nicely and have helped tremendously in holding down some other teams' good scorers.
So to touch again on, you know, your number 6, Michael Ferentz. Mm-hmm. He's been playing lockdown defense back against Dover. He really helped contain Ty Vitko, current state-leading scorer. How much of a boost is he the lineup when he gets in that game?
Oh, he's huge. He's an energy guy from the get-go. And he knows that, and we push that in practice with him, and we expect that when we come. That's why we love having him come in when he does. A lot of teams, when you go to the bench, you go to those 6 guys, 6th or 7th guys, they get a drop in their energy level. He raises ours. When he comes in, he's diving on the floor. He's doing all those little things that coaches love that you can't always chart and you can't always do that, but you can see our play go up. You can see our guys get an extra bounce in their step. And for us, when we're playing with that kind of energy, we've been playing pretty well. So, you know, that when he comes in, that we go up a level typically.
So turning back to last week, yep, you guys played Exeter, undefeated versus undefeated. Yep. You guys played really well. You guys went into half with the lead, but kind of, you know, Exeter got their groove and they did end up coming out victorious. Mm-hmm. Take us through that game and how the team has reacted to that since.
Well, they weren't happy with it, with the outcome, obviously. We were excited going in. The kids were looking forward to playing them again. We had played them in the Christmas tournament as well, and it was a 3-point game. So we felt like we could play with them. We felt we could go in there and get that. I thought we came out pretty well. We didn't shoot the ball particularly well. But, you know, we fought and we stayed with it. Our goals going in, you know, if I could have told you we were up at halftime at Exeter, you'd take it. We held their top 2 scorers to 24 points on the night. We helped them on the night to 43, which I was pretty thrilled with defensively. I just think offensively we could have been a little bit more patient. Shot selection here or there could have been better. We turned it over a few times than I would have liked late, that kind of opened the game up for them. But we were up 1 with 5 minutes to go and had a legit shot. So from a confidence point of view, we know we can play with them. And if they're the number 1 team in the state, then we feel like we could play with anybody. And I think the kids react that way as well. Like I said, they weren't happy with the loss, but they know what they need to do. They know they can go into a hostile environment and compete in that level. And hopefully that'll pay dividends as we get further on in the playoffs start.
So to take, you know, throughout the whole season, you guys have definitely won the games that you guys should mm-hmm. win. You know, one of your first games, you guys beat a very talented Spalding team, yep, by double digits. Your home opener against, you know, some may say your mentor, E.J. Perry, blew the guys out the gym.
Yeah.
How is the team really taking it game by game? How are they, you know, buying into the process?
They're doing a nice job. I mean, we've looked at and tried to tell them, let's make sure that we do what we do and take care of our business, not necessarily worry about what the other team's doing to a degree, and play our game. Doesn't matter, try not to look at the records, which is very difficult to do. But know that when you're one of those teams that people are talking about, teams want to come in and get you. You're going to get everybody's best shot. It doesn't matter what their record is. You're going to get everything they have because that could make or break their season. So our guys have, for the most part, done a pretty good job with it. I think we've had some ups and downs here and there where we started a little slow. And once it clicks into them that we really got to kick it in and do what we do, we've kind of opened those games up. So there was a couple games after Christmas that were tight early on. And then we kind of woke up a little bit and realized what we can do and then kind of opened up those games. So hopefully, you know, we're going to continue to do that as we go game by game. But it's a mental thing that we're always working on, right, being prepared for everybody.